dindaro guavo, non mi dà come no.
Hello? Good morning, fellow mourners. On behalf of Ambassador Katana, I welcome you all and thank you all so much for being able to come and join us as we celebrate Mao Organzo's life. Our program is not so long. We'll begin with the church. We'll have a prayer, then they'll lead the coffin bearers to here. Then after the church, we'll have laying of wreaths. Whoever is called upon will come here, but won't touch any wreath as we follow the SOPs of Ministry of Health. The pallbearers, one of them will get the wreath straight to you and put it on the coffin on your behalf. Please do not touch any wreath. Then after the laying the wreaths, we'll have speeches. Then after speeches, it will be the church again. And after the sermon, they'll lead us to Mao's final resting place. So that's the program for today. Thank you. Just for information, after the service, the hearse will go round with the coffin, but all the rest will pass there. There's a shortcut, there's that small black door there, that's where we'll pass. Then the hearse will come round like that and join us there. Thank you. Sebabe kanisa, twabakira, kandi turede kutandika service. Ready when you are.
Yebare nonga mutebekanisa wa program kandi nabantu mwena ntubakira twaza kwemerera twena twatanise umukeshongoro icya 2006 twena twemerire utampingura mujuni ntwakira umberwa wa mnywano waitu. O tampingula muzuni ninkutachira korataya yirabandi nanyutansiga Yesu mujuni ninkutachira korataya yirabandi nanyutansiga onyirize yenewe pewe mbabazi simbira majuni ntonja okukwesiga Yesu ninkutachira korataya yirabandi nanyutansiga tinyi nundije muzuni okwiaiwe oyambira njira buzune yesu nsa Nasire.
Yesu,
Yesu, Mujeni, Ningota Chira. Magara ompobo sinje tinyini masikwa gani kureka ewe Yesu Tajira kora taya ira vandi na nyutansiga. Beloved of God, we welcome all of you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ as we join together to celebrate the life of our brother, our son, our friend, that the Lord has loved to call and take away from this world of sin into another new life in heaven. And we use the words to comfort the family, the brothers and sisters, and all of us gathered in his presence. We shall use the words in the Bible as it is written in the Gospel of John, where our Lord Jesus Christ himself said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he dies, he shall live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. We brought nothing into the world, and we shall take nothing out. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble, as we read in Psalm 46. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies and compassion never come to the end. They are new every morning. God so loved the world that he gave his only son, and whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. I'm sure that neither death, nor life, nor angels, or principalities, nor powers or things present, nor things to come, nor height or depth, or anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in your Son Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and assurance of hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may live as those who believe in the communion of saints, in the forgiveness of sins, and in the resurrection in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. We shall remain standing, and our brother Reverend Paul will take us through the reading of Psalm 39. It is not in your booklets, but please remain standing as we listen from the Bible.
Psalm 39, I'm reading from the English Standard Version. I said, I will guard my ways, that I may not sin with my tongue. I will guard my mouth, with a muzzle. So long as the wicked are in my presence, I was mute and silent. I held my peace to no avail, and my distress grew worse. My heart became hot within me. As I mused, the fire burned. Then I spoke with my tongue. O Lord, make me know my end, and what is the measure of my days. Let me know how fleeting I am. Behold, you have made my days a few handbreadth, and my lifetime is as nothing before you. Surely all mankind stands as a mere breath. Surely a man goes about as a shadow. Surely for nothing they are turmoil. Man heaps up wealth and does not know who will gather. And now, O Lord, for what do I wait? My hope is in you. Deliver me from all my transgressions. Do not make me the scorn of the fool. I am mute. I do not open my mouth. For it is you who have done it. Remove your stroke from me. I am spent by the hostility of your hand. When you discipline a man with rebukes for sin, you consume like a moth what is dear to him. Surely all mankind is a mere breath. Hear my prayer, O Lord, and give ear to my cry. Hold not your peace at my tears, for I am a sojourner with you, a guest like all my fathers. Look away from me, that I may smile again before I depart and am no more. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Amen. We shall take our seats and we receive the first reading this morning. You want to take us through the first and second readings, please, you come together and you take us through the readings.
Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God. Believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that? I'm going there to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. That's the word of God.
Thanks be to God. The second reading.
Second reading, there is a time for everything and a season for every activity under the heavens, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The one in charge to take us through the next part of laying the wreath.
Thank you, church. We have a few wreaths to lay. It shouldn't take long. When I call you out, please just come and stand here. This gentleman will help you put the wreath on the casket. We'll begin with Ambassador Katana.
Ikeshongoro ikigana cyenda na bibiri uryo mu mikono ya Yesu tagera cyatina twatanise ntumurizana nibwambe byo uryo mu mikono ya Yesu tagera cyatina kando muhumurira mu amara rukundo ye nimpurira amara ka
The second one is Mao's mom, Sale Kagonzo Papa. Please come and play your rhythm.
Niva imbi sabati bati ori oryo mumikono ya Yesu tajira chatina
kandi
kando muhumurira mu amara rukundo ye.
The third breath the third wreath is for Mao's daughter, who is not around, she couldn't make it. So it will be laid by Manuel Chema. Please come and represent Gabriela. Then Mao's siblings, represented by Pam and Jeje,
Tajira chatina
kandi
kando muhumurira mu amara rukundo ye.
Then the next one will be from the Joseph Virwonwa and the large Nguza family, represented by Roger.
Mukama wanje Yesu.
Another read from the late Godfrey Sabiti's family, Stephen.
Come on, present.
From the Babumba family. Don't know if there is anyone to represent the Babumba family, but you can still put it on.
We shall join together in hymn 182, What a Friend We Have in Jesus, as we continue with the exercise of laying the wreath.
You can put it on.
What
then the next one is from
Jesus.
Mr. and Mrs. Lutega and family.
What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. All because we do not care.
Another read from the larger Kappa family, represented by JJ. JJ.
Have we trials and temptation? Is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find our friends so faithful? Oh, will all our sorrows share? Jesus knows
then finally,
the
the church.
The Lord in prayer. We come heavy.
We come heavy laden. Come, but with a load of cares. Gracious Savior, still a refugee, we listen to our prayer. Tukute
tendereza Yesu Alimana Gwandega Yesu Musa Ikuna Zeze Treva Zanye Yesu Mulokozi.
Thank you all. Now we are going to begin the speeches part to listen to the eulogies. And please try and keep them short because we only have a few hours that we were given. So we'll begin with a speech from Mao's friend, a representative of Mao's friends. Please come and give your speech. Is that mic there? Then after this, we'll have a speech from Mao's maternal cousins, represented by Trevor. Please, Trevor, be ready. You'll be next after this.
My name is Samuel Okwakol Atubet, and I'm standing here with Stephen Nagimesi. We represent the scores of friends that Mao has had. This is a very tough time. A life cut short. I knew Mao from the early 90s in Busoga College, Mwiri, where we attended secondary school. I've known Mao in different capacities. As a friend, I was humbled to know him because he was a genuine friend and never disappointed, always stood by his friends. In LDC, I was his roommate in LDC when we were doing law school in LDC. And he liked to boast about how for the years we were roommates, we never had a fight or had a disagreement or anything. I also knew Mao in the capacity as a colleague. We worked together at Okwakol and Company Advocates. And he was always up for the challenge, regardless of how little it was. He was always up for the challenge. Mao was a very, very humble person. He avoided conflict and confrontation, always walked away when he got mad, and preferred to associate with people when he had cooled down. We had dreams, and dreams of the future, and sadly, those dreams have been cut short, but we will continue with his dreams. Would like to assure Mama and the family, Pam, that we'll stand with you during this tough time, and we'll always be there. Second Timothy chapter 4 verse 7, I have fought the good fight, I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Rest well, Mao.
Michael, please kindly give me 1 minute. I'm very sorry. I have to say this. Frank, but Mao, as we fondly knew him, is a very good brain. Ladies and gentlemen, Frank Mao, we met in law school. I was in first year, he was in third year. But we attracted each other because we were both good brains. I have a daughter who is turning 7 years next week. But when she was born, I named her Gabriela after Mao's only child. Gabi in Denmark. We planned to go and see her with Mao maybe a year ago. COVID messed us up. Frank did not tell me how to live life. He lived it and let me learn. Rest in peace, Frank. Rest in peace, Auntie Sally. I spoke to Mao so often, even about you, and we fondly called you a Kiki. I am very sorry, Pam, and the rest, Joel, the rest of the family. God be with you. Be strong. May the good soul of that man repose with God in peace eternally. Rest in peace, Frank Mao Kapa Ruganzo. I called him the second. Rest in peace.
Thank you, friends. Trevor, on behalf of Mao's maternal cousins. After Trevor, it will be Roger Virivonwa on behalf of the larger Nguza family.
My name is Trevor Karugonjo. With me here is Martin, who was dubbed Cousin Muscles by Mao. I'd like to appreciate everyone who's here with us today. And Julius, sorry. I'd like to appreciate everyone who has come with us here today, supported us financially, spiritually. Mao was a brother. He wasn't a cousin, he was a brother, an elder brother. He was kind, he was witty, he was intelligent. He taught us many lessons. You present a problem to him, and the first thing he would say is, it's neither here nor there. It's neither here nor there. Even before he said anything, whether it was a difficult thing or he went to him with a good news, he'd say, it's neither here, whatever it is. Let's first celebrate that we're here. The book of Proverbs, chapter 12, verse 25 says, anxiety in a man's heart weighs it down, but an encouraging word makes it glad. Mao had that word. When I was much younger in Bulindi, when we'd go home to our home in Bulindi, and our power would go off at night, and I'd be scared. So I'd be sleeping next to him. I tell him, Mao, I can't sleep. And he tell me, okay, you put your hand on my head. And I'd put my hand and nod off. And in the morning I'd wake up with my hand, but he'd be gone. But I'd have slept. And those were his solutions. Simple, practical, to the point. He was my go-to guy, our go-to guy. Now the go-to guy is gone. Mao, death has taken your body. But I know God has taken your soul. I'll treasure the memories. I'll keep the love. And I know I'll see you again someday. Mau, Omucheke, Ka Brown Brown. I love you, man. Rest well. Rest well.
The clergy, Ambassador Katana and the Kappa family, Kantandike, maybe to show you the family that has escorted Aunt Sally, Abarugire Bulindi Chali Mwemere, Babarole. Thank you. We bring condolences on behalf of the larger Nguza Kargonja family from Bulindi Hoima, where Mao's mom, Akiki Sale, is born. My name is Roger Virvonwa, an uncle to Mao, but also a close friend because of our slight age difference. On behalf of our family, I wish to appreciate all the support that has been given during this time. And in a special way, thank Ambassador Katana and the Kappa family for giving our dearest Mau a befitting send-off, especially in these very trying and challenging times of COVID. We also thank you for raising him into the gentleman he has been. Mao shared his love. Sorry. Mao shared his love equally, paternal, maternal, especially when he visited us in Bulindi over several holidays, like you've heard from his cousin. He really loved his mother. He made rounds whenever he was in Hoima with the different family relatives. The bond between us and the Kappa family will continue nonetheless. As a friend in the family, Mao has been humorous and very witty. He was always happy, light-hearted. He loved to read, was grooming himself into an intellectual, challenging some of the journalists in the press. He always tried to make light of a situation. When he realized it was getting heated or emotional, he was known to tell very entertaining stories until the wee hours of the night. And as children, we struggled to keep up, especially with his stories. We would be laughing late into the night and would struggle waking up to catch up with our dues for the next morning. His friendship has been genuine, really genuine. Majority of his friends dating back to primary school, probably 30 plus years. Within the family, he has been steadfast in his relationships, respectful to his elders, very cheerful to his age mates and his siblings, his cousins, nephews, and nieces. As this day of sorrow comes, tears in our eyes, loneliness in our hearts, we say goodbye to Mao. Thank you for sharing your life with us, for the blessing you have been, and we'll never forget you. Even when the sun sets and the rain falls down, God is indeed amazing, for knowing who we were with you. We'll miss you, Mao. Rest in peace, Mao, till we meet again.
Thanks, Roger, and thank you, Trevor. Now, as you know, many people are not able to come, but they managed to send messages. We've got some which were recorded in this booklet. You read them. And we've got some other recordings. I'll ask these gentlemen to play some of them.
Hi, my name is Miriam Lacare. I was Frank's classmate in primary school from P1 to P7. Yesterday in the morning, Frank was part of a conversation laughing at the jokes that were on our WhatsApp group. And so it was with profound shock when later in the day, we got the news that Frank was no longer with us. Frank had passed away. Frank was a very outgoing person, the kind of person who kept friends. If we thought about him, you always remembered him with a particular friend. He loved to party, he loved to dance. And in the class WhatsApp group, he was really an outgoing person and always outspoken. The last time I spoke with Frank, he called me up and he talked about specifically his concern about the aging, the elderly. There was one person in his life that he was concerned about. We made plans for our own old age. And then he told me about a book that he was writing. He believed he had gotten to a point where he was ready to publish. And I encouraged him. I said, Frank, that is amazing. I can help you to get this published. And he said he'll definitely do it in the next 1 or 2 years. He has gone now. His book is not published. But I hope that the family that he loved so much will be able to find his writings and that they will be something to hold on, part of him that will never go away from them. Frank, on behalf of the ladies of Class 7B 1990, I want to tell you that we already miss you, and we pray that God will receive your soul in his kingdom. God bless you. Goodbye.
My name is Aravasa Raymond Kananura. I'm almost a lifetime friend of Mao that departed. We condole with the wider Kappa family and his daughter that he's left behind. We are very saddened by his unexpected departure. It's left us all a bit shell-shocked. We're not quite sure how to handle it. It's caught us off guard. We felt like we're still young and maybe fairly invincible. But this has sort of from the cat amongst the pigeons, as one of the phrases Mao used to use a lot. Mao had a playful fluency with all the languages he spoke, not just English. Mao held himself to a higher moral standard. He demanded it of himself and by extension the rest of us. And he kept challenging us. He was quite despondent about the state of our nation and maybe Africa as well, about moral decay. He craved for so much more from each one of us. And I think he's left that with us to try harder and make sure that we get out of life what we must and do it in the right way. You're going to be dearly missed, Mao, and your legacy is going to live on with us. As a group of Kitante alumni, we've heard that there was a book that Mao had written, but it hadn't been published yet. We're going to ensure that we work with the Kappa family to make sure that it gets published so that our brother can live on. Rest in peace, Mao.
Hello, family and friends of Mao condolences to you all. Very sad close to the week. My name is Brian Mungereza. I've known Mao for 40 years, I can say, right from nursery school all the way to date. There's so many things I'm sure that are going to be said about my brother Mao. He was such an intelligent guy, funny guy, witty. Of course, people are going to talk about how he was writing a book. Yeah, his book, he's left behind an incomplete book, which my friends of 7V, his classmates of 7V, have pledged to help, you know, complete and publish. What I can say about Mao that for me stands out about this great guy is that he was extremely loyal. He's one of those guys that was trustworthy. I remember in primary school, something really, really embarrassing happened to me, and I shared it with him, and I asked him not to say a word. Quite embarrassing. And he was like, you know, the secret is safe with me. And true to his word, up to today, he'd never mentioned it to anybody. But every time he and I would remember that day in primary school, I think must have been P4 or P5, would just laugh. And you know, he never said a word. You can imagine a primary kid to be that, you know, that that loyal and trustworthy at that age. And he stayed true to his character till his demise. Mao was proud, was very proud, was a proud father to his beautiful girl. He never spared a moment to show her off. Whenever I think about her, actually, you know, it hurts me even more. But Mao, all I can say is that we'll miss you, and this pain won't go away. It's really, really, I hardly slept last night. And all I can say is that once this lockdown is lifted, I'm going to get the boys together and come down and pay our last respects. That's all I can say for now. But fare thee well. Bless you, Mao.
My name is Tom Ogara, a close friend of Frank. Unfortunately, he's not with us anymore. I met Frank about 37 years ago. Same class, same desk. P1L, that was in Kitante Primary School. We eventually went separate ways in terms of schools, but not in terms of, you know, friendship. We kept in touch when we could and you know, spoke a number of times. More recently, we got into a group of our former class, P7, that stream, that P7V, as we call it. And for about 5 years, we've been in touch, you know, and we chat almost every day. He's been family, really. Sad that he has left us untimely. No one ever knows when we shall all go. But he always talked about a small island. Whenever we had all these discussions on the group, and we feel, as a team, feel frustrated either by politics or government or some of the things that are going on in the world today, he'd always say he's planning for his small island where he'd stay alone, and we always said we shall also be there with him. Sincere condolences to the family, his daughter. We are going to miss him, was a great guy. Yeah, stay well. Frank, rest in peace till we meet again.
My name is Henry Zizinga, and I would like to add my voice to the rest and send my heartfelt condolences to Frank Luganzo's family. It's quite absurd that Frank has left us unceremoniously, but that's the reality, and we've got to accept it. Frank, I first knew him in 1984, that was Kitwanji Primary School, and my first memory of him, he was holding court, but that was Frank. He loved to hold court, he loved to tell stories, very jolly man, very intelligent, very widely read, a man with a big heart. And as we went our separate ways, through the advent of social media, we got back together. Me in particular, I was away for a very long time. But as I settled back in, Frank was instrumental in getting my company registered, consultancies, correspondences, and the like. Even as we set up groups, investment groups and the like, Frank was still very resourceful. He helped us with the consultancies again. Yes, he was widely read. I don't remember anybody who was more widely read than Frank was. You know, one particular trait I picked from him was to be decisive. Frank was never in the middle. He was never on the fence. You knew where you lie with him. It was either this or the other. He was never in the middle. And I think that's a very important trait for us to have, especially leaders. So we're going to miss him dearly. Frank, we're going to miss you. You've left quite a void. The WhatsApp group you've been on is already somber and quiet, and you can imagine. So to the family, our condolences to you. Be strong, seek solace in the Lord. And to you, Frank, may your soul rest in eternal peace. Till we meet again.
To Frank's vast and impressive extended family, but most especially to you, Gabriella, his beloved daughter, allow me kindly to extend my sincere condolences for the loss of Frank Mao Ruganzo Kapa yesterday, 15th of July, 2021. My name is David Kamgisha, and I have known Frank since 1987, so we've basically known each other for 34 years. With the wonders of social media, a few years ago, a group of us reconnected. Actually, I would say maybe the entire primary school class or stream reconnected, formed a group, and basically we've been at it virtually every day since then. So people who you talk to on a daily basis essentially become family. And Frank was family. To you, Gabriella, your father was beloved. He was a fine gentleman with a lot of positive attributes. And for me specifically, and maybe to speak for the group, we will dearly miss him so much. To his other family, please accept our sincere condolences, my sincere condolences. It's a great loss. To Frank, wherever you have gone, please prepare a place for us, because we intend to link up with you once again. Your departure was sudden, shocking. Some of us are still shaken, and we didn't get a chance to say our proper goodbyes. Rest in peace, my brother, until we meet again. Take care.
Those are messages from Mao's friends. Don will pass them on to Ambassador Katana and Pam to share with the rest of the family. Now, there's another message from Mao's sister, Margaret Kapa Mulira, who lives in the UK. unfortunately, she can't make it. So she sent a message. I'll ask Robina to read that message. After that message, if there are any other messages, please let me know. After Robina, it will be chairman who will talk on behalf of the cousins. You're going to represent the cousins, chairman.
This is a condolence message from Mao's elder sister, Margaret Kamrari Kankunda Kapa. Dear family and fellow mourners, I am saddened by my brother's death. I know, my brother, that heaven has called you, but you would have stayed. At least the memories I have with you will forever be in my broken heart, and you'll never be alone. Frank Rugonza Kapa, you were one in a million and will be dearly missed. All by those who are lucky enough to know you. My brother Mao, you forever have a special place in my heart. I forever cherish the good times I had with you whenever I came to Uganda. On behalf of my maternal family, the Nwama family, my children, Kiza and Waswa, I hereby express our deepest and heartfelt condolences to our whole family and all who are grieving with us. May my brother's soul rest in eternal peace. Frank, you will forever be remembered, forever beloved, until we meet again. Margaret Kankunda Kamrari Kapa.
Thank you, Robina. Chairman. After chairman, it will be Pam Kapa on behalf of the siblings.
Fellow mourners, my name is Arnold Agasha. I'm commonly known as chairman. The relationship I had with Mao, my mom was a sister to Mao's dad. On behalf of Mao's cousins, we are so saddened by his demise in this untimely manner. Our sincere condolences go to Uncle Katz, Mao's siblings, JJ, Pam, Noella, and his daughter Gabriela. Me personally, I had something I shared with Mao. I think both of our nicknames had the same origin. It's not until April this year that Mao gave me that information. Actually, I didn't know the origin of our names. I'm so saddened that you're gone, my brother. We are going to miss your love, your sense of humor, your laughter, your guidance as an elder brother, and we shall always remember the happy times we shared together and the few times that our hearts broke as one. Rest in peace, my brother.
Thank you, Chairman. Pam, on behalf of the siblings.
My name is Pam Kankunda Kapa. I'm Mao's elder sister. Our journey with Mao started from when God decided we'd be siblings. Not that I'm complaining, it was one of God's best gifts. When we were young, we lived between here in Ruharo. Kaka's house is down there. That's where we used to play from. And Rukunjiri at Kaka Deborah's place, the Karekaho family home. We did early schooling in Rukunjiri with Mao doing early nursery there, and me doing nursery and P1 in Rukunjiri. Before moving to Kitante, I moved to Kitante in P2, and Mao went to nursery. We rode the journey of life together, mainly because we were close in age, but we also cramped each other's lives at the same time. Soon after, our siblings Joel and Noella arrived. Mao, as a sibling, was laid back. Unconfrontational, very intelligent, very funny. He loved and respected me. It was annoying sometimes. I think he thought I was a magician. Every time he got a chance, he would tell people, "This is my big sister." It would be so annoying because it's a big sister, tell them my age, 2 years apart. And as we grew older, it was really annoying. But now I know he really loved and respected me. Anyway, a background on what happened to Mao. He lived alone. So when I heard that we were going into lockdown, I called him and asked him to come and stay with me because it was going to be a long one. Mao was so independent. He liked to live alone. He said to me, "No, it's fine. It's kawa," as he said. "I'll be fine." Then he says, the following day after the announcement, he called me and said, "I think I should come because this is going to be long, 42 days. Then I said, "How are you going to come?" "I'll get a border." I said, "From where? Everything is locked up." Then he said, "Okay, let me walk." Then we arranged, somehow I managed, and we got him a ride and he came over. When he walked in with his rucksack and his laptop, he said to me, "Thank God I came. I've been having these weird chest pains, but I read about it on Google, and it says anxiety causes them." I didn't think much of it, because Mao and his weight, in my opinion, it wasn't any issue. He used to even say to me, "I don't have issues. My friends, they've all cut out milk, I don't know sugar, I don't know what, but me with my weight, I don't have to do anything." Anyway, I told him, for me, I do regular walks, and we are going to start tomorrow. I'm sure he was saying, "Oh God, why did I come here?" But anyway, he stuck with me. We started the walks, and I remember the following day, I rang Uncle Katan and I told him, I was checking on him because of the lockdown and the COVID was so bad. So I checked in on him, and Uncle Kat said to me, "How are you guys?" "We are fine." "Your brothers, are they okay?" Meaning Joel and Mao. "And to you, they are fine. Mao is with me." Then he says, "Good, look after them because I'm not barring anyone. You have to make sure you guys keep safe." I said, "Don't worry, Mao is with me and Joel is in Bombo." So we started the regular walking. We do regular walks. There's a time we walked and got lost in Buziga. It was close to curfew time, 6:30, we ended up on Salama Road, heading to Entebbe Road because we were completely lost. I think we did like 15K that day. Mao was ahead of me. I was running behind him. Mao, wait for me. He had left me. We were panicking. People were saying we'd ask for directions. Ah, munatuka sawa meka. LDA basi. Me, anyway, we managed to get home in the end. Anyway, he was fit. He was really physically fit. Because all those walks, he would be ahead of me and it would be me struggling. But on those last few days before he died, about 2 days before, he started complaining of a headache and a migraine. And then he said, I normally get these migraines, but I think I know how to deal with it. But he was in his room. He kept staying in his room nonstop. I kept going in and he said, oh, I'm just watching a movie. Oh, I'm reading. I didn't think much of it. So he died on Thursday. On Tuesday, he didn't walk with me. I walked by myself. When I came back, I was sweating. I went in, I told him, look how I'm sweating. It has been a long one. People were even hooting for me on the road. I was going up the hill. I really did it this time. So the following day on Thursday, when I got up, I went to his room. I asked him, are you going to come to walk? He said, yeah, he was actually already ready. So he got ready, we started walking. He asked me, where are we going to pass? When I told him the route, he said, yeah, that's going to be a long one, which was unusual because it wasn't any other longer route than we had taken. We walked up the hill. As we walked up the hill, he was fine. We reached the top of the hill at Tank Hill Road. Somehow he went behind me. And as we were walking down towards Kawalagala, I heard him calling me, Pam, I think let's chill a bit so that I can sit down. I feel a pain in my chest. So I let him, I looked at him to see if it was serious or he was dehydrated or he wasn't in the mood for walking. He sat down. When he sat on the side of the pavement, I asked him, where is the pain? Left or right? Trying to figure out, is this a heart attack? Which I wasn't even imagining that it could be. He says, no, it's just in the middle here. So I called a border person to come and pick him up, to take him to the clinic near home. I said, let me call the border guy to come and pick you up. When I said that, I was actually hoping he'd say, no, it's not that bad. Let me just chill a bit and we walk. But he just said, okay. Then I thought, this must be serious. So the guy came and took him. Then I said, I'll walk down following you. When I was walking down following them, I called them to see whether I had reached. And they told me that they were there. He was on pain medication. Then the doctor said to me, it was something like angina, a heart condition, which I thought, okay, at least we know what it is. He's looking for the medicine for the angina. Then, as I actually said, let me get home, shower, and then come. But before I got home, I called Aunt Carol, who lives nearby, and asked her to, if she knew anyone who had an X-ray around and a clinic with an X-ray. So, we started getting ready to maybe move him to a bigger place to see what was happening. Then the guy calls me from the hospital and says, madam, what is it? Kubanga kati, Mr. Mau, simtegera. Then I said, what is happening? Ntibata and Sogamba, heart failure. I said, heart failure? I thought this guy didn't even understand what he was saying. So I started running now to go to the clinic. By the time I got to the clinic, he had actually already gone, but they hadn't told me. Because when I went to the room to see him, he was lying down, like he was sleeping. So I was asking them, what's going on? Then they said, you first calm down. So I went out. In my heart, I was saying, if Mao is dead, I don't want to see that. If he's going, I don't want to see that. But anyway, then they said to me, they came outside where I was sitting and they said, Mao is gone. And that was it. So really, that was Mao's life. But I want to really thank God for the gift of family. Because after that, I said to myself, what am I going to say to people? I even asked the doctor, what am I going to say to people? This is someone who was normal 1 minute, and the next minute you're saying he's dead. I even thought they had done something to him. So after that, family took over. I remember calling Uncle Katz. I don't even know what I told him. I must have scared him because he must have been trying to figure out what I'm saying. I remember Sven calling me and saying, Pam, don't worry, I'm going to come and pick him up. Then I was thinking, is this really happening? Anyway, that was his life. That was how Mao's life ended. But thank you, everyone, for being there for us. Thank you for helping us, for Mao to have a good send-off. Mao, may you rest in peace.
I'm Joel, Lieutenant Joel.
Sorry, Joel. That's Mao's younger brother. Thank you, Pam. Our next speech will be from Mao's mom, represented by the sister, Caro Karukonjo. Then after the speech, we'll have the final speech from Ambassador Katana. Then we'll hand over to the church after Ambassador Katana's speech. Thank you.
My name is Caroline Karugonjo Mugoya. I'm standing here with Eunice Karugonjo. We are younger sisters of Sally Karugonjo, Mao's mom. Therefore, we are Mao's aunts, maternal aunties. I'm sorry. I don't know, the sun is too... Excuse me, sorry. It's a bit dark. Mm. Okay.
Can you see now?
Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, the light is not bright enough. Oh, now I can see. I'm speaking on behalf of Mao's mom. Oh, God.
Can you see?
Friends, family, and the Ruharu community, all protocol observed. I'd like to start by thanking you all for standing with me during this very difficult time. In very challenging periods of our lives. Specifically, now it just gets dark, so I don't know. Okay. Yes. Specifically, I'd like to appreciate the Kappa family, my family, and my friends in all your different capacities. I'd also like to thank the doctors, medical staff of Nancy Vancha Clinic in Bukasa, and all who assisted Mao when he was rushed to hospital. Let me start by telling you briefly all about my son. Mao was born on Tuesday, 11th January 1977 at around 1 p.m. at Mengo Hospital, Kampala. When he was born, he was a chubby child and looked like a Chinese. His grandfather, Uncle Andrew, said he looked like Mao Zedong, the then Chinese president. This is how he acquired the name Mao. I thank God for his life and feel blessed to have had him for his 44 years. Mao was humorous, like you've all heard, witty and extremely intelligent, which enabled him to excel in his career. He loved to read all sorts of books. He was extremely knowledgeable about everything. He always made me smile. Mao had a way. Mao had a way with people. He loved to spend time with his friends. If it were not for the travel restrictions, we wouldn't have enough space to accommodate all his friends. I would like to appreciate his friends that have made it here today to bid him farewell. Mao was very positive and always forward, looking, always hopeful about the future. He was a peace-loving person and always brought people together. Just last week, he called and told me about his upcoming plans after lockdown, and he thanked God day and night for his life. That's what he told me. I believe that my son is in God's hands and made peace with him. He loved and cherished his only child, Gabriella Magdalene, and was always in touch with her, encouraging her, and gave her hope to accomplish her dreams. Gabby, I love you and will always be there for you. Losing a child is painful, and I'm comforted by Isaiah 41:10, which says that, "Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I'll uphold you with my righteous right hand." Mau humurombusinge apuliwage. I will always love you and will miss you immensely. Your loving mother, Sally Kargonjo Akiki.
Thank you, Carol. Our last speech from Mao's uncle, Ambassador Patana.
Kulaja sikukan kutendereza abantu bashitama
tendereza Yesu wali mwana gwandega Yesu msai kunazi zeze twebazanya Yesu mulokozi.
Thank you. I think speaking two languages, partly because some of our visitors may be more familiar with English than Runyankore. The clergy, familiarity now, okunkugira family nabarga bunyoro abakargonjo nemo mur family banywani bekeji na banywani ba mao aba mena batara hati evrotnar ran inzara kantu yaban old age now, but I'm comforted by two things, Sally and family. There is now a familiar mode of doing this kind of occasion. And I know my daughter and others who are familiar with me must be saying, oh God, there goes Dad. He's going to teach us. Correct. There are two things that happen. When you look at the booklet, it says celebration of the life of Mao. At the same time, everybody who came here was crying. I am crying because two things happen. We celebrate the life that God gave him, the life we enjoyed as family and friends. But at the same time, there is another side of the coin, which is mourning. We've lost somebody. I ain't going to be kidding you, Okwajira Ngu, all is fine and dandy. It is not. We are mourning the departure of Mao. Mao, Omukayeitu, especially Omukaya Frank Kamrari, Nwe abaireye orkweta eya ningomska. Omuchinyankore ninjangu nomuchinyoro omuojomkuru nwe askirish. So Mao has been the heir to the Kamrari family. The fashion is slowly changing, but that was the fact then. People have described Mao, so I don't think there is much I can add on. Mao, as they said, was a gentle soul. Who wouldn't hurt a fly? Mao was, in his own way and among his friends, an intellectual giant. He spoke few words, but his command of English was amazing. He read, didn't talk much, but when he talked to you, there was a sense of a deeper understanding of that knowledge. He was unassuming. You know, this attitude is, I think, inherited in the family. Mao was Mao. Humble. And as I was thinking, probably unassuming to a fault. And as Pamela has said, to a certain extent, he was bordering on a recluse. He liked to be alone. But he enjoyed the company of his friends, especially sitting at the counter. I'm sure they would be speaking all kinds and manners of English and drinking all kinds and manners of stuff. He used to visit here a little bit less than JJ. And I kept saying, "No, you guys, you need to come. There is a piece of estate at the end of our land." And I was telling them, "You guys, I'm a very old man. I'm hitting 78. If you don't come, I'm going to get squatters to take over the land. Better still, I am going to sell it. And I will go down in history as having sold my children's land." So they did oblige Pamela, Mao, JJ, Noella. They came and started developing the piece of estate. Now, about 2 weekends ago, I am minding my business, as I normally would say. JJ says, "Oh, we are on our way." I said, "I hope you are with Mao." I said, "Yeah, I'm with Mao." 2 weekends ago, they came. We had lunch, and it was reaching my me time. I said, "Okay, going to your project, may I need my rest?" I was expecting Frank and his wife. They came. This place here is strictly out of bound because of the circumstances. But once a week, Frank, who I will introduce later, and I sit down in this compound and shoot the breeze. So about 6 o'clock, we are doing social distance. And I think Mao brought his chair here near this Calero tree. Frank was there, and so on. He had his black and white. My brother there had his Jamesons. I had my Gordons. Robin had her tea, and so on. So we chatted and chatted. It was a very beautiful evening. So eventually we parted. We agreed to have breakfast and go and inspect the real estate. So we went, we talked some. Then I left them. So Ruganzo saunters in through that gate. You know how he used to walk, as if he has no energy. And I'm looking at him. I say, "Mao, Mao, 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 put in some life. Do you see that picture? If you look at the booklet, you'll see his constant smile. I never saw him angry. He was unassuming. Then at times I would say, but Mao, please, how about putting on a lawyer's suit? Because I'm tired of your jeans and these shirts you are wearing. We are meeting at a Fairway Hotel, you come in jeans. We are meeting at Serena, you are coming in jeans." Says, "Oh, uncle." Then he smiles. So I think I'm okay. You know his English. That's all right. So, the next day, I tell these folks, the workers, pack some food. And I always insist people leave early. So they left. Reach Kampala, Mao sends me a message, we are fine. You know, Uncle, I'm staying with my sister, who is like you. I say, in what manner? Says, she won't let me out of her sight because of COVID. I had told her, I said, look after your brothers, because I'm not burying anybody because of COVID. So she said, oh, I'll look after them. So 2 weeks later, must have been at about midday, Pamela calls me. She's hysterical. I said, what has happened? What has happened? I thought it was one of the elderly people. Say, Mao, Mao, Mao. I said, what has happened to Mao? He's just been here. Say, Mao, Mao. I said, compose yourself. Mao, Mao. I said, is he okay? Has he been hit by vehicle? Is he an accident? So no, I think she's dead. He said, he's dead. I said, where are you? Some clinic. And I knew that Pamela was not functional at that stage. So I called my brother Don. Thank you, Don. I think you can wave people. I called Don. I said, Don, we've got a big, big problem. Go and see what has happened. I think Don organized. I called JJ. I said, JJ, run. I don't think he had heard. I said, go and be with Pamela. So the Kampala group got together. Shortly after, I got a call from Don Sylvain. They in Kwame, Birivonwa, Joseph. So the Kampala group got together and arranged a befitting farewell to our son, father, and colleague. In Mbarara, immediately I called Frank and I said, look, Frank, I am in a situation, a very difficult situation, because I didn't want to tell him on telephone. So I said, you take your lunch and afterwards come. Says, what is it? So I think I sounded desperate. So Frank said, no, no, I'm coming. Frank came. We talked. I appraised him of the situation. And he set the ball rolling. And we agreed, God, who gave us Mao, God has decided to take him. There isn't much we can do. All we can say is pray for his soul to be where it should be in God's kingdom. Lastly, let me thank I will not be mentioning names or the people who have come to our aid. My workers here, headed by Bosco, the service providers, my daughter here, who I had told not to come. She said, oh, you live alone, so I'm coming. How are you going to stay in this house alone? And all my sisters and brothers called me, hey, you're alone, you're alone. I said, I'm a tough cookie. I can survive. But they insisted she came. I'm with her. And I bring greetings and the messages of condolences from my siblings and other relatives. Kamkama family are in Montreal, you'll see their messages. Margaret is in Rendon, France, and her family. Kankunda is in Washington with her family. Noella, the sister, had just left for university. MC, don't kill me. Noella, right now, I think, is with Paul Ratstarate, who sent me a message that they're picking her up to be with them. The Shalita family. Auntie Deborah, my aunt and the mother to Michael, called me crying. And I was telling Michael, I said, your mother almost sent me to my other grave. She called me and said, Inurinyankore, we know what. Those who know Nyankore, it means your end has come. Without tomorrow, your end has come. I said, I'll be there. I'll be fine. Nyakato, who is an aunt, couldn't come because of these restrictions. But they are with us in spirit. And they had asked me specifically to mention messages. So Sally and the Kargonjo family. Lastly, I'd like to thank the clergy. Reverend Eric and his colleague, I just called him in the morning. I said, we have a situation. Come and be with us. So yesterday they were here. Today they are leading us in a service. And I got a condolence message from the bishop, who I also had notified. I thought I might not say anything, by the way. All of a sudden, I'm speaking. All of a sudden, I've taken 1 hour. So, lastly, thank you all very much for coming to grace this occasion. If it was not for the restrictions, these places would be filled. And I must apologize for those who are listening, who I had specifically said, sorry, you can't come, because we are observing a scientific occasion. And there are others who wanted to bring wreaths. I discouraged them because of the situation we're in. JJ, there is a little protocol thing we didn't do. We have relatives of Claire. That is the mother of Gabriella. And they called me. Sorry, I said there is no wreath to be done, and Could you stand up? At least people recognize you. The relatives of those, the aunties of Claire and grandmas of Gabriela, I thank you very much for coming. Organzo, you didn't tell me about the book, but we look for it. I had the book somewhere. I suspect he wanted to surprise me, but you can be sure, wherever the manuscript is, if you dig it up, we shall be the biggest supporters of its publication. Once again, thank you very much for coming. Sorry for this longish, probably boring speech, but I will also wish you, for those who are going back today or tomorrow, a safe journey. Mao has gone. He's probably up there looking at us and saying, what are these guys doing here? My friends, they're even crying. My friends from university and the Lord Women's Centers, I thought we are made of a bigger stand of stuff. Let Mao rest in eternal peace. Thank you.
Thank you, Ambassador Katana. And thank you for being strong. This was our last speech. I got one message to you, Pam and Sale and Katana from Mwembeja, Diana Teyegala. And there's a wreath from your office, Pam, Transform. They brought a wreath. So they have a message for you. They'll give it to you. It's right there. Thank you so much, Pam's colleagues. We are done with the speeches. Now we are going back to church. The church is taking over. Sermon, and they'll lead us to the final resting place. As I told you earlier, the casket will be taken around. Then the rest will walk through that small gate. And as you're walking out, please observe all the SOPs. Have your masks on. Keep a distance. Don't get so close to each other. Yeah. Church.
Thank you very much. We're going to join together in hymn 162, Uganda Youth Praise, There Is a Redeemer, as we prepare our hearts in the continuation of the service.
There is a Redeemer, Jesus, God's own Son, precious Lamb of God, Messiah. Thank you, oh my Father, for giving us your Son, giving your Spirit, the work on us is done.
Jesus, my Redeemer,
Jesus, my Redeemer, name above all names, precious Lamb of God, Messiah, oh, for sinners slain.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, O my Father, for giving us your Son and living in your Spirit till the work on us is done.
When I stand in glory,
when I stand in glory, I will see His face, and there I will serve my King forever in that holy praise.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, my Father, for giving us your Son and living in your Spirit to work on us is done.
Gracious and loving Father, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we stand before you in all our weaknesses of our bodies, Heavenly Father, to praise and thank you, for you have stood with us and you have remained faithful to us. We give you glory for all that have spoken about the life of our friend Mao that you have chosen to take. Heavenly Father, I want to thank you, for you have done it well. And Lord, here we are, praying that you comfort our souls, praying that, Lord, you will give us the strength. Mao has gone, but life must continue. And Lord, it cannot when we are not with you. We pray that you will be with us, and may you shower your Holy Spirit unto all our hearts, that Heavenly Father, we shall stand to see you and understand, so that we live according to your will, and your name shall always be glorified through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. As a church, we want to stand with fellow mourners and family, the entire Kappa family and all the relatives. We want to thank God for everyone that has managed to make it, because we are not in good days. There is almost like confusion. You don't know what next. But we want to thank everyone that has come to be with this family, to stand with you in these trying days. On behalf of the church, St. James Cathedral, the dean, the head of laity, the wardens, and all the Christians, we bring our condolences to the family for the loss of our dear brother, Frank Mao. This is the message from Dean's office, and I will read it as it is. St. James Cathedral, Ruharo and Kole Diocese, to the family of Ambassador Katana, condolence message. The Dean, staff, head of laity, and the entire Christians of St. James Cathedral, Ruharo, convey their heartfelt condolence to the family of Ambassador Katana for the death of your dear son, Mao. May the Almighty God give you strength in this challenging and trying moment. Remember that God is the one who gives and who takes away. If we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die, we die for the Lord. Romans chapter 14, verse 8. we have contributed Uganda shillings 100,000 towards the burial arrangements, and may the Almighty God continue to comfort and strengthen you. May his soul rest in peace. It is signed by the Very Reverend Canon Herbert Begumanya, Dean, St. James Cathedral. MC, you can receive sanitize, and then you take it to the ambassador. You're welcome. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, those who are here and those who are viewing and listening to us, there is something that we need to understand, especially these days, when things are like changing. Today, as we are giving speeches, celebrating the life, as Ambassador has put it, physically mourning the loss of a brother, and spiritually celebrating because as believers we trust that he has moved from this earthly life to eternity, and that makes us to celebrate. There is something we need to think about so that as believers we begin to prepare. God's timing. I'm praying hard that God may give me the strength and wisdom that we may understand that phrase of God's timing. One gentleman made a comment that if I would face God face to face, I would ask him questions that he would not be able to answer. And as we are here, so many questions we have. And at times we ask and again go on to find answers for ourselves. Only that unfortunate part of it is that we get wrong answers because we ask wrong questions. And today, we need to understand God's timing. First and foremost, when we read in Genesis chapter 3, death is inevitable because it was the wrong choice of the first woman who disobeyed God and chose to eat the forbidden fruit. And instead of eating from the tree of life, because maybe she was so swift and quick, she did not want to be noticed, she picked fruits from the tree of wisdom. And because of that, there was a curse and death started then. And therefore, every living creature is a suitable candidate of death. And I want to assure you, brothers and sisters, that very many times God has spoken to us, but in our human nature, it is always hard to understand how he speaks. I would imagine, when the sister of Mao called, "How are you going to survive in this lockdown? Come and be with me." It was the Spirit of God speaking. The planning of the previous 2 weekends to Pran and his brother and come to visit here, you may find it was the Spirit of God speaking.
But this could not be understood in our human nature, and for us to say his departure has been untimely. Indeed, in our own understanding, it is very untimely because we did not want him to go. But spiritually, in the spiritual world, to the Maker and Creator who put him on earth, it was the right time. And therefore, me and you who are here, we even don't know our own time when we are to leave. Now, this, from the lesson we read in Ecclesiastes chapter 3, it is God who put time for everything. But the unfortunate part of it, he did not reveal this to us. And I believe, on the other hand, it was so good for us not to know. Because if we knew, maybe there would be chaos in this world. But because we all have hopes to live, at least that makes us to be humble a bit. And now, that is what we must do as believers. When we read in the book, the epistle of 2 Peter, chapter 3, verses, we shall use 4 verses only. And in verse 10, this is what he says. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief. The heavens will disappear with a roar. The elements will be destroyed by fire. And the earth and everything in it will be laid bare. The day will come as a thief. Now, when you are preparing to sleep in the night, you make sure all your doors, all your windows are closed. And not only closed, but even locked. Why? Because you never know, a thief may come. Meaning, even during the day when you want to leave your home, you make sure everything is locked. Because there is what you expect, something not good at any time. And when you are doing all your activities, you don't think about that thief that may even steal and take your life. And where you lock the house to protect the property in, where do you lock your life so that you are protected? Because you don't know the time, and that day will come as a thief. You can imagine coming to Mao after a walk, just a minute, not expected. And in the same way, it will. And in verse 11, listen. He says, since everything will be destroyed in this way, what kind of people ought you to be? You ought to live holy and godly lives. Praise the Lord. The only thing that we need is to live holy. By the way, if there is anything hard on earth, is to live holy. Ay, 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 ay. It is very, very complicated. But I want to assure you that good things are always hard to get. Very hard to get. Valuable things are kept far and very much protected. And I don't think there is something valuable on earth than our own lives. Praise the Lord. Therefore, what we need is to live holy, holy, and live a godly life. When you look at what is happening today, you imagine. The other day, there was a WhatsApp video clip where this husband was fighting his wife. I imagine during the day in the public, and you beshame your own wife without knowing you are beshaming yourself. When I looked at the video, I was blaming three people majorly. First and foremost, I was blaming this woman coming to his husband, to the husband, when she was not prepared. Because it was too much exposing all the parts of your wife to the public. I would say, yanda huire ndukuma ngutinye tekate chire ni nyiruka. I was imagining this person who was holding the phone, you know, taking the recording. Are we human? Instead of helping these people not to fight, you are taking fun of it. That is not godly life. That is not godly life. People are using this lockdown to have the opportunity to steal people's property. That is not godly life. Because he tells us, when you continue in that very chapter, in verses 12, he says, as you look forward to the day of God and speed its coming, that day will bring about destruction of the heavens by fire, and elements will melt in the heat. But in keeping with his promise, we are looking forward to a new heaven and a new earth. Praise the Lord. When that day comes, everything is destroyed. And you know, when we say destruction, it means there is loss of value. Loss of value. The friends of Mao here were talking of his dreams. His dreams are no more, completely destroyed. Now, you may have time in your dreams because you said you want to achieve, and there is the biggest dream that you need to have. That is your life after here. Praise the Lord. There is that hope. And you must work for it, because if you don't work for it, then you will not have it. He continues to tell us in verse 15, before 15, verse 14 says, so then, dear friends, since you are looking forward to this, make every effort to be found spotless, blameless, and at peace with him. Praise the Lord. There is something you need to struggle for. And the struggle should not be for the mansion. The struggle should not be a human-looking car. The struggle should not be having so many ranches. But the struggle should be to be found spotless and blameless. Praise the Lord. To be spotless and blameless. And you imagine how to become spotless and blameless in this world that is full of dirt. May God help us. Mao has gone. We are following him. We don't know when. But will you go when you are spotless? Will you go when you are blameless? Will you go when you are at peace with him, the owner of your own life? Something you need to think about. We give glory to God for those that have tried. Because when someone says, make your effort, that means it is not easy. Konka jezo. Echirikumanyisa ngu tibyanguhi. Konka jirota jezaho. Oteho mtima. Okujezaho okaturaje na bagenzi bawe. Okujezaho okagira obusingye na Ruhanga. That means that when you try to live at peace with him, you are not doing what is contrary that annoys him. And of course, when you read in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 58, he tells us and he assures us that our labor in him is not in vain. When you try to live that spotless and, you know, that blameless life, your effort is rewarded. And you know, when God rewards you, there is joy. I imagine what will happen in heaven when you meet, not in any pain, not in any form that embarrasses. Omulinyankore nabagirango turiya Yesu turyashemererwayo. Praise the Lord. Turyashemererwayo hatakiruho kuremura, because ntuisha kwa tachine na ku zensege. And I imagine, you know, those who wrote the Bible, there are so many words they omitted, I believe. Because bajira nguturiashemererwayo, there must be the opposite of it. Hatini chimanisa avatarishemererwayo baryarirayo. And what we must struggle to get out is to suffer here, and you again suffer in heaven. And there are those who say there is no suffering, because you know when you have money, it is like there is no more suffering. But I want to tell you, rich people don't sleep. When these people with 1,000 in his pocket and he takes his wallet, he even sleeps on the way. A rich man cannot sleep on the way. No way. But the other man has his PC. He knows now, when you take me, what do you take? Only life, it is only you have. Meaning, there is a lot of suffering here. And our prayer is that we live spotless and blameless so that we don't even suffer when we reach there. Praise the Lord. When you analyze the speeches of the friends and everyone here about his life, when you find these jolly people, by the way, jolly people don't even grow older. They remain young. Why? Because he is at peace with everybody. There are those who do not sleep because they hate someone. Imagine. You even fail to eat when the other person is just adding soup. No, you wanna wanna says achi. Kurara noreva. O karara norra. O kare mwakuria. Undisha muna yonjere mboga. Nguiwa no mwanga. Apana. They can't kunde na nyembiri mwenu. Why? Why are you making yourself suffer? Because we are living in a world that is full of spots. And it wants to darken everyone. With all that we see, that we love. When you read in the episode of 1 John,
chapter 2, verse 15. Can you listen what he says here? Do not love the world and anything in it. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. And that means you are now having spots for yourself. You are looking for the brim because you love the world. You love the world. For everything in the world, the cravings, the sinful man, the lust of his eyes and the boasting of what he has and what he has done comes not from the Father, but from the world. And the world and its desires pass away, but the man who does the will of God lives forever. Praise the Lord. Living forever does not mean that you will not die. Please understand. But living forever is that you are living here and you will even live in eternity. And that is what we are fighting for. Very many people here have used a great term that has been missing these days. Mao, we shall meet. We shall meet there. Now I want to ask you, if he goes to Gehenna, will you find him there? Now, we all wish him and wish ourselves that we shall meet in heaven. And therefore, if we are to meet him, we must live spotless and blameless. Praise the Lord. And if we are to live spotless and blameless, we must not love the world. And it is very confusing because you can't imagine how we love this world. How do you hate the world? How do you hate money? How do you hate cows? How do you hate these beautiful women? It is hard. But put your effort. Praise the Lord. Put your effort. When you put your effort, your labor in him is not in vain. It is my prayer that we would all put our efforts. This world would change. Today, people fear to move during the night when there are no lions. Today, people even fear. The other day, I came to visit this old woman here. And I think she's here. When I came, I found the house was locked. In and out. I thought she was not there. When I went, I met the daughter, the grandchild that stays with her. She told me these days, she just gets in and puts all the pads outside. Why? Because, you know, she may be in sleeping and she will come during the day even. People don't fear. They even steal during the day. To the extent of even stealing in the church. Oh my God. Are we not inviting curses on ourselves? What must we do? We must repent. We must repent. That is when things will be okay with everyone. That is when God will forgive us. And that is when we shall become his own children that he loves, that he trusts. And he will say, all of you, come to me and you have your rest. Praise the Lord. It is all that we need. It is all that I wish everyone to repent. You become a true, faithful child of God. And let me tell you, Ambassador Katana talked of something that when these boys came, he took them and they went to the estate. I did not go there with them because I'm not part of them. There is time when God will be sharing his blessings to his children. It will be so sad if you don't find yourself to be a child of God. You will not share his blessings. Be a faithful child so that you share from his blessings. As a father gives to his children, it is the same way that God will give his children. May God bless you. Let us pray. Gracious Father, we bless your name and we thank you, for your word is sent not in vain. And Lord, you have spoken to us. We request that you give us the strength and understanding by the Holy Spirit that we repent all our sins, so that we live a life that is spotless, that is blameless, and we are able to join your eternal life when we change from this earthly life. Heavenly Father, we pray and we confirm that it is the same way that our brother is going to live. And in the future, we shall be able to jubilate with him as we sing, as we dance before you. May you stand with the family physically. May you take the position of Mao. And Heavenly Father, may you take the position to stand before the family members, the siblings, and Lord, we pray that you stand with Gabriela, his daughter. May you stand with friends, that whenever they raise their eyes, they will be able to see you. You will comfort them. Heavenly Father, you will give them the rest, and they will live hoping to meet with Mao in eternal life. Be with us, Heavenly Father. Continue to bless your people as you have blessed them coming. May you continue to bless them as they go back. May you continue to bless the family members that will remain here. And Lord, in your name we pray that all shall come to be well with us through the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And may the peace of God that surpasses all human understanding be with you and remain with you, to acknowledge the love of God and his Son, Jesus Christ. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you, remain with you, now and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Tokote tendereza. Yesu,
Yesu
ali mwana gwandega. Yesu amsai kunaze zeza twebazanye. Yesu mulokozi. The church today has been presented by my brother Reverend Paul Akatukwasa, is a chulet in St. James Cathedral, and myself Reverend Noel Eric. Bwana Ambassador, we would be here in big numbers, but because of the situation, the church declared that we should not have more than two to represent the church on any function, and that's why we are supposed to have one priest and one lay reader, but because we came together, so don't mind about the big numbers, but all the dean, the bishop, as you said, they are aware, they are with you, they are praying for you. May God bless everyone. If there are no any more announcements, we shall proceed.
Just to repeat the same announcement, the casket will go into the hearse, then they drive around. The rest of us are going to pass here. Will be led by Katana and the rest of the family members. Then the others can also follow. Please keep social distance.
We all stand as they move their casket. We sing hymn 191. More kama na jirati nyowe ndi hamwene iwe oreche kuchiro woba omuru jendo rawe omu mwiri mandindi Nandagani sati yagumande amweniwe tindi kusiga winka nyowe tindi jira obusigere nyinka Nandagani sati Siga winka ebintu byona ebyensi birauka kuwaho ninke birabyo byomose okubiwunduka konka Yesu tekwali Atura nandagani sate tini kusiga weka kunde kwa wakari nebi chereze mukama wanjogo Yesu aya Yesu
Thank you. Kushaba ahampa pura maganaviri chenana neina. Omuntu zaire gumukazi amarebero bicho munsi kanda sura ijire naku. Amera kanda temwa kecherabyo ahabo afaho kechichuchu kandi taguma mwanya gumwe. Tubatsikire omagaraga tubatsikire yo mukufa. Wenu twongere ahariyoha kureka hariwe Mukama haza ugwerirwe kubi ebe byitu nosinga konka ayi mukama ruhangura kwera munonga ayi mukama w'ubushobozi bwona ayi mukama witor kwera w'embabazi nyingi utatwayo umukufa okurumu oburizi oburizi okwebiro nebiro mukama witu nomanya imbonano yona iyo mutima iyo mitima yetu otita amatugawe agembabazi okangukura okushaba kwetu kure ko sasire mukama urukwera munonga rwango busohoze bwona umujono urukwera kandi wembabazi umuciwe manja ushire kandi utabaho utatwikereza kurugaho umbona kugo kufa abohorizi ba rufu
cyesongoro igana 35 abatekayo esanduke sayo no mwiguru
sayo no mwiguru
Wanga wanje,
wanga wanje,
wanga wanje,
wanga wanje,
wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje, wanga wanje,
Shabe, kukura hanga, usoboro zibuona simbele ya wimba wazi nyingi. Tuara umoyo kwa mwine wito ugumawu, urukumu watugaho. Choturuktera, mtugumu itaka, takumu itaka, nijomu izu, mchucho mchucho. Tuinama sikuwa gaha militari kubangana sangwariyazo, chero magaraga chawahu, abwa Yesu Kristo mkama wetu. Urukwindire mbiri yiti yemyere mwakuba nkumbirwe namani ubwo kitinisa namana gambasa kwegomora byona twena nkahurira nkahurira kirukurwa mu gurune rigerarti handika ukuyati bintu mushabafa bafiri mu mukama yego nuko mwo yari kugera ngo babone kumurira kimumera baname yabo ayi mukama wito tugerere mbabazi
ayi Kristo tugerere mbabazi
ayi mukama wito tugerere mbabazi tatayite tatito mu guru izina rya Yesuwe ukama bwo kwije iyo kunda kuri umunsi kuko babikora mu guru utate byo kuri yotutosha sasire byo kwita kwitu kito sasara kushagiza tatwara mukoiba kure ko tuzomba bi amina
wango bushobozi bwona tusima abo kuba inyonyo y'abafera umuri mukama wito eturaniwe kana magaraga bari kwesega ko baheza kwihaho uburemezi bwo mu berogo bagumaniwe umukishemererwa no mukunanuka ngero ntwisima munonga abo kuba kunzira kweta mwite mwine witogu mao okuruga umunakuzenseji yezi kana ntweshengereza abo burunji bw'embabazawe ukize kukiriza juba umubaro gw'abatorinwe bawe no kurafusia ukama bwawe ngitwe hamwe n'abafire bona nibikereza kimwe izina ryawe rukwera kuturika umukitinisa cyawe kitaruhaho tunje okushemererwa ukwishyire kimwe uko mubere no ko moyo abwa Yesu Kristo mukama wetu
amina ayiruhanga wimbabaze isho mukama wetu Yesu Kristo ubu kuzokana magara sima abo kuba umuntu we no rukwikereza no buyapfa ryabo hurira muriwe kandi we no ruhurire kandi urukumwikereza tarife byona kandi Yesu Kristo bakatwengesa nara bo muntu maye Paulo urukwera kutashamirire kutongeza bari kwejegera muri we nk'abatine masiko we na ita tite twesengereza no bucirezi tuzore turyo mu kufa kwe kibi tutaho magara go kwikirira turi batwarigira mu magaraga umuru muriwe kuktwi na masiko hari minywano we itogu mao ngunuko yaba kandi akuzoka kw'abantu bona kiro cy'amperu cyangwa turya bari kwikiriza ubwo misho gawe kebwo mu gisogo ubwo mwana wa uwo kunda mnonga arahaba ari kukunda kandi abari kubyina nagira ati mwije mabutata yahira umukisha muhungu rubukamo bw'abateka tekigo kuyakwangwa kwenzi ahita atitwe mbabazi twishengereza utereze ibyo abwa Yesu Kristo muterano wetu kandi umucunguzi wetu amina imbabazi za mukama wa Yesu Kristo no kunda kwabaranga kwatanisa ku moyo rwera meneje twena nabishemebona ati nibiro byona amina icyoshongoro abanyabuzare nibagumizamo ukitayo akataka ninge kimuri kandi turi kugumizamo
oryo mu mikono ya Yesu tagira chatina
kandi
mu muriramu amarwaro Nipurira amalaka galatu wandizeyo Nila mwesho urira niba imbisabati Ori
oyo mumikono ya Yesu tajira chatina
Amen.
We can move back, and the people concerned do the needful to cover, and we finish.
When your day's down here or through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who've lost their way, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your day's down here
there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeve, and if you're trying to be the change you wanna see, if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you.
Hello?